Henrique slots it ahead. It got on to Kovalchuk, and Kovalchuk a shot that's carefully played away by Lundqvist. Now Ponikarovsky with it. Through one in front, blocked there. Scramble for it there. They poke away at it. Still it's loose. Poked out by Kovalchuk. They score! Henrique! It's over! Gets this puck to the front of the net. It's just a mad scramble. Olczyk Ponikarovsky throws it to the front of the net. Everybody's down. I thought the puck was going to end up in right there. But Adam Henrique beats Brad Richards to that loose puck. And Henrique did it against the Florida Panthers. And he did it against the Rangers tonight to go to the Stanley Cup Final. Marty Brodeur is at the very end of the line. We are always intrigued by how goaltenders, fellow members of the defensive union, greet one another. That's a long time off right now as he shakes hands with the Rangers captain, Ryan Callahan. Mike Rupp is very close to him. You know, they had that little incident earlier, and they are together now.
Please stand by for the official presentation of the Pennsylvania.
Up like welder's helmets, made so many sparkling plays in the series and even in this game, and then it ends and they meet. Zach Parise, Pierre McGuire.
Thanks very much, Doc. Your first trip to the Stanley Cup Final. You're soaking it in right now. But how did you guys keep it together when you're up 2-0 and they come back and tie?
Well, they're a great team. We expected them to give us a big push. They played hard the whole series. They made it hard for us. But the whole time, we felt if we could keep it 5-on-5, we had a chance.
You played in a major overtime game in the 2010 Winter Olympics. One of the things you told me is your team didn't have a lot of energy after you scored the tying goal. What was being said in your dressing room before you came out for overtime?
It didn't matter how we got to overtime. You know what? We're in a good position. We're at home. We just needed one shot to get us there. My God, it feels good.
Marty Brodeur is 40 years of age. He's a guy that's been playing with a chip on his shoulder. Did he say anything to you guys before this pivotal game six?
No, he was quiet, and you could tell he was in the zone, and he led us. He made some big saves tonight.
Congratulations, and go enjoy the trophy. I don't know what you're going to do with it.
You'll see.
Okay, we've been given a warning. Kevin Clark, the public address announcer, will make the introductions. The Prince of Wales Trophy. Since the 93-94 season, when the Rangers captured it by being the East representative in the Stanley Cup Final, it has been presented in the East, and it will be presented now.
Bill Daly will now present the Prince of Wales Trophy to the Eastern Conference champion, New Jersey Devils, Captain Zach Parise.
He has apparently thought about this.
I think he got some advice from his elder statesman in goal.
Nice table, nice trophy, not on your life. He waves the whole team out there. What a night for New Jersey. The rookie scores, Henrique from Kovalchuk and Ponikarovsky at 103 of the OT.
Well, Doc, we talked about the most important area of the ice, the play in the middle of the ice by the New Jersey Devils. The Rangers try to fire this puck, the stretch pass. It's kept alive by Andy Green, and now the Devils are off to the races. They have strength in numbers. They win a physical battle. Ponikarovsky just fires it to the front of the net. Now it's a two-on-one in front of the net. McDonough down. Richards is there, and then Adam Henrique finally finds the puck in behind and puts it into the empty net. Net presence, great stop there by Lundqvist, but somehow that puck finds its way right to the goal line, and Henrique puts it in. But again, the play in the middle of the ice. The Devils, or the Rangers, tried to stretch pass. The Devils shut it off. And they head to the Stanley Cup Final against Daryl Sutter and the Los Angeles Kings.
And there you see,
yeah, the reaction from the bench. Look at Larry Robinson. Hugs all around. Assistant coach Adam Oates. And no better feeling than to be in one of those piles. And a reaction from Marty Brodeur.
He weighs a little more than most of them because of all the equipment and responsibility. The Warriors. Downstairs to Pierre.
Thanks a lot, Doc. You've got a lot of experience doing this kind of stuff. First round, game seven, double overtime, you score the series winning goal. Here in game six on home ice, you score the series winning goal. You're going to the Stanley Cup Final. When the puck's on your stick and you see the net wide open, what are you doing?
That one was like Christmas. Pony and Kobe got jarred loose and fell through his pads, and I'll take it.
Marty Brodeur is a veteran player. He's been around this league for a long time. He's won three Stanley Cups. What can he tell you as a person that's never been in the final before about what it takes to prepare for the Cup?
He's our leader. He's been our leader all year. And, he's the best goalie in the world for a reason. And, we lean on him night in and night out. And again, tonight he played great and kept us in it throughout the game.
We'll see you for game one of the Stanley Cup Final on Wednesday, Adam.
We'll see you there.
Doc, the son of Joe and Teresa, tobacco farmers near Brantford, Ontario, Burford, Ontario. Brantford made famous by Wayne Gretzky. And he said the planting took place a week ago, so he didn't have to be back to help out this year. Coming up on the Bud Light postgame, Keith and Mike and Liam. Devils advance to the Stanley Cup Final. Complete reaction and breakdown, and we don't mean nervous, I don't think. That's ahead on the Bud Light postgame show. Game one of the Stanley Cup Final, presented by Geico, will be Wednesday, 8 p.m. Eastern Time on NBC. Twice they played a millennium ago in October. The Devils won both of those, one a shutout by Johan Hedberg and the other a shootout win by the same goalie. Freddie Olczyk, Pierre McGuire, Doc Emrick saying goodnight from New Jersey. The Bud Light postgame show is next.